So now I'm going to start with the Kingdom Monera. Kingdom Monera was for the first time proposed by the scientist. I have already discussed about him while I was discussing the four kingdom system of classification. So the Kingdom Monera was proposed by Dougherty and Allen. These were the two scientists who proposed this kingdom. And initially Monera was known as Mycota. But later the name Monera, the term Monera was given by Dougherty and Allen. Monera is the kingdom of all the prokaryotes. Jitne bhi prokaryotes present hain on the entire earth, they all lie in the kingdom prokaryotes. So Monera is the kingdom of all prokaryotes. ठीक है, prokaryotes they arise from the earliest form of the living stock, that is the progenote. तो prokaryotes कहाँ से arise हुए हैं? They arise from the progenote. The earliest progenote is also known as the earliest living stock. Right? Now, अगर हम members देखें, इनमें कौन-कौन से member रहते हैं? तो mainly the main sole member of the prokaryotes monera is bacteria. Bacteria is the sole member, and its other forms are also present here, like mycoplasma, actinomycetes, cyanobacteria. So these are the form of the bacteria which are the member of the kingdom prokaryotes. Now let's see about their organisms. What are their composition? They may be organisms of Monera. They may be unicellular. They may be colonial. They may be filamentous. They may be unicellular, colonial, or filamentous. Filamentous in case of cyanobacteria. And they may be mycelial. That is actinomycetes. ठीक है, हैबिटेट की बात करें, सो द प्लेस दे कैन सर्व, दे आर कॉस्मोपॉलिटन हैबिटेट. अगर इनके हैबिटेट हम देखें तो दे आर कॉस्मोपॉलिटन. दे कैन बी फाउंड इन द एक्सट्रीम ऑफ द कंडीशन, एक्सट्रीम ऑफ द एनवायरमेंट कंडीशन. वी कैन फाइंड देम इन हॉट स्प्रिंग्स, वी कैन फाइंड देम इन द सॉल्ट पैंस, इन द सल्फर स्प्रिंग्स, in the snow. So they are cosmopolitan in nature. Cosmopolitan. In the extreme environmental condition you can find the member of prokaryotes, like they may found in snow, in salt pans, hot springs, sulfur springs, so they are cosmopolitan. Now cell wall, let's see. Ab hum iske, let's see the cell structure. Cell structure or cellular structure. Ek general cellular structure aap Moniran ke dekhenge. So first we will discuss its cell wall. Cell wall jo thi Moniran mein, jaise maine bataya ki it comprises of bacteria, it comprises of archibacteria which are found in extreme, which in acidic condition or extreme hot springs. So and there are certain prokaryotes where the cell wall is present. So cell wall in case of archaebacteria, in case of bacteria, cell wall is made up of peptidoglycan, peptidoglycan jisko ki main PG likh rahi hu, aur murine bhi kehte hain. In case of archaebacteria, cell wall is made up of pseudomurine. This peptidoglycan is also known as murine. And there is a prokaryote where the cell wall is absent. So in case of mycoplasma, mycoplasma mein kya hota hai? Cell wall jo hai absent hota hai. Cell wall is absent. Right? Now let's see the components of the peptidoglycan. The main, the whole soul member, or the main member of the prokaryote is bacteria. So, and its cell wall is made up of peptidoglycan. So this peptidoglycan is made up of three parts. Peptidoglycan is made up of three parts. First is polysaccharide. Polysaccharide mein it contains three types of the sugar. That is, three types of the sugar are glucose, mannose, and galactose. The second component of peptidoglycan is amino sugar. तो इनमें दो तरीके के एमिनो शुगर्स होते हैं, एन एसिटाइल ग्लूकोसामीन विच इज ऑल्सो नोन एज नैट, एंड एन एसिटाइल म्यूरमिक एसिड. सो लेट्स राइट इट्स नेम. फर्स्ट इज नैम, एन ई एम, नैम, एन एसिटाइल म्यूरमिक एसिड, राइट. एंड सेकेंड इज एन ए जी, नैट, that is N-acetyl glucosamine, N-acetyl right. So these are the three types of the amino sugars, and several amino acids are also present. The main important amino acid is diaminopalmitic acid, DAPA. ठीक है, डापा, डी ए पी ए, डाई अमीनो पाइमेलिक एसिड, डाई अमीनो पाइमेलिक एसिड विच इज फाउंड इन बोथ यू बैक्टीरिया एज वेल एज इन ब्लू ग्रीन एल्गी. तो दे आर फाउंड इन बोथ ब्लू ग्रीन एल्गी, दैट इज साइनोबैक्टीरिया एंड यू बैक्टीरिया, राइट. द अनदर एमिनो एसिड इज म्यूरमिक एसिड, एंड द थर्ड एमिनो एसिड इज टाइकोइक एसिड. सो दिस इज द कंपोजिशन ऑफ द सेल वॉल, जस्ट आउटलाइन of the cell wall of the prokaryotic cell. I will discuss it in detail later when I will deal with the bacteria independently, whole soul individually. Now the next feature, first we have discussed cell wall, the next cellular structure is cell membrane. So cell membrane in mein present rahegi. Yes, cell membrane present rehti hai, and there is only single membrane present in the members of the kingdom prokaryota. Jo prokaryote organisms hote hain unme sirf ek hi membrane present hota hai, and that is the cell membrane, and due to this they are also known as the single membrane envelope.
system. ठीक है, दे द ऑर्गेनिज्म विच फॉर्म्स द सिंगल एनवलप सिस्टम. तो प्रोकैरियोट्स दे रिप्रेजेंट सिंगल एनवलप सिस्टम. Why they represent a single envelope system? Because there is only single membrane present. Now there is no any organelle, such organelles present which are bound with the membrane. जबकि हमने देखा है यूकैरियोटिक सेल्स में जितने भी organelles होते हैं, most of the organelles are bound with the membrane, either one membrane or the two membrane. And yes, some membraneous organelles are also present there. But in case of prokaryotic cells, not a single membrane bound organelle is present. Totally membrane bound organelles are totally absent. Only the membrane is present, one membrane is present, and that is the cell membrane below the cell wall, right? Third is, ab hum third lenge, cytoplasm. साइटोप्लाज्म में क्या होता है, मेम्ब्रेन, जस्ट मैंने आपको बताया कि मेम्ब्रेन बाउंड ऑर्गेनेल्स आर टोटली एब्सेंट, राइट, ओनली मेम्ब्रेन लेस ऑर्गेनेल इज प्रेजेंट एंड दैट इज राइबोसोम. मेम्ब्रेन only membrane less organelle is present. ठीक है, membrane bound organelle totally absent है, सिर्फ membrane less organelle present है. example, that is which membrane less organelle is present? Ribosomes. Ribosomes are the protein factory and ribosomes are present. Kis type ke ribosome present hote hain prokaryotic cell mein? They are of 70S type. 70S type ka ribosome jo hai prokaryotic cells mein present rehta hai. Now in the cytoplasm of bacteria or monera prokaryotic cells, True vacuole is absent. Generally cell के अंदर क्या होता है, ये cell है eukaryotic cell में true nucleus, true vacuole present होता है. तो here this is true vacuole. But in case of prokaryotic cell, जो है true vacuole absent in prokaryotic cell. So, अगर true vacuole absent है तो क्या होगा, there will be no streaming movement of the cytoplasm. Eukaryotic cell में this is eukaryotic cell, structure of eukaryotic cell. यहां पे क्या होता है, cytoplasm shows the streaming movement. ठीक है, तो अगर true vacuole absent है, vacuole है ही नहीं true vacuole, तो क्या होगा, it will result in the एबसेंस ऑफ साइक्लोसिस, यानी कि साइक्लोसिस जो है वो एबसेंट होगी, साइक्लोसिस नहीं प्रेजेंट रहेगी. ठीक है, हाँ ट्रू वैक्यूल नहीं है, उसकी जगह पे यहां पे जो है गैस वैक्यूल प्रेजेंट होते हैं कुछ ऐसे प्रोकैरियोटिक सेल्स में which need to be provided with the buoyancy. So these gas vacuoles, they are air filled, they are gas filled, and they provides the buoyancy to the cell to float in the liquid medium. Now nucleus ki baat kare agar, to in case of prokaryotic cell, true nucleus is absent. ट्रू न्यूक्लियस क्या होता है, ट्रू न्यूक्लियस में जैसे ये है ट्रू न्यूक्लियस, इसमें न्यूक्लियर मेम्ब्रेन प्रेजेंट है, न्यूक्लियर मेम्ब्रेन के अंदर क्या है, न्यूक्लियोप्लाज्म प्रेजेंट है. ठीक है, दिस इज न्यूक्लियर मेम्ब्रेन, न्यूक्लियर मेम्ब्रेन के अंदर क्या प्रेजेंट है, न्यूक्लियोप्लाज्म प्रेजेंट है. और इसके अंदर जेनेटिक मटेरियल प्रेजेंट है. ठीक है, दिस इज जेनेटिक मटेरियल और साथ में न्यूक्लियस के अंदर वन और टू और फ्यू न्यूक्लियोलस आर प्रेजेंट. बट इन केस ऑफ प्रोकैरियोटिक सेल न्यूक्लियर मेम्ब्रेन इज एब्सेंट. ओके, न्यूक्लियर मेम्ब्रेन इज एब्सेंट, न्यूक्लियोप्लाज्म इज एब्सेंट एंड न्यूक्लियोलस इज एब्सेंट. Only this genetic material is present. So such type of nucleus is known as incipient nucleus. तो यहां पर कैसा nucleus present होगा? Incipient nucleus, which is also known as nucleoid or genophore. ठीक है, अब क्या होता है, आप क्रोमोसोम की कंडीशन देखते हैं. क्रोमोसोम जो प्रोकैरियोटिक सेल्स में क्रोमोसोम सिंगल क्रोमोसोम प्रेजेंट रहता है, सिर्फ एक क्रोमोसोम प्रेजेंट रहेगा, विच इज डबल स्ट्रैंडेड एंड सर्कुलर, राइट. तो ऐसे क्रोमोसोम को क्या बोलते हैं, इन केस ऑफ प्रोकैरियोटिक सेल इट इज नोन एज प्रो क्रोमोसोम. तो यहां पे प्रो क्रोमोसोम्स प्रेजेंट रहेंगे विच आर सिंगल इन नंबर और वन इन नंबर एंड दे आर डबल स्टैंडर्ड सर्कुलर डीएनए. दे आर मेड अप ऑफ डबल स्टैंडर्ड सर्कुलर डीएनए अलॉन्ग विथ सम नॉन हिस्टोन प्रोटीन्स. यस, हिस्टोन प्रोटीन्स आर एब्सेंट इन प्रोकैरियोटिक सेल. सो दीज डबल स्टैंडर्ड सर्कुलर डीएनए दे आर प्रेजेंट अलॉन्ग विथ पॉलीएमिन्स. पॉलीएमिन्स आर they are non histone proteins. ठीक है, in case of prokaryotic cells histone proteins are absent, right. Now next is thylakoids which performs photosynthesis. In case of bacteria, in case of monerals, autotrophic mode of nutrition and heterotrophic mode of nutrition both are present. So to perform an autotrophic mode of nutrition it requires thylakoids. There is the chloroplast. Plastids are absent, as we have already discussed earlier that membrane bound organelles are absent. So there must be some organelle which will perform the process of photosynthesis, right, it will perform the formation process of the food formation. So for that the thylakoids are present, but these thylakoids are lying embedded in the cytoplasm. Okay, so they are not formed in the form of grana, they are not formed, they do not form the stake. Okay, so thylakoids are present in the cytoplasm, they lie freely in the cytoplasm. Next, about the respiration, इनमें जो है they perform both aerobic and anaerobic respiration. Both aerobic and anaerobic respiration. Now nutrition, इनमें nutrition कैसा होता है, let's see. मैंने बताया कि न्यूट्रिशन इसमें दो तरीके का न्यूट्रिशन होता है, ऑटोट्रॉफिक भी होगा और हेटरोट्रॉफिक दोनों होता है. दे परफॉर्म बोथ ऑटोट्रॉफिक न्यूट्रिशन एंड हेटरोट्रॉफिक न्यूट्रिशन. लेकिन ऑटोट्रॉफिक और हेटरोट्रॉफिक मोड ऑफ न्यूट्रिशन में कि इन दोनों के अगर बात करें तो इन दोनों में हेटरोट्रॉफिक मोड ऑफ न्यूट्रिशन इज मोर कॉमन. दिस इज मोर कॉमन इन प्रोकैरियोट्स. अब ये जो ऑटोट्रॉफिक मोड ऑफ न्यूट्रिशन है इट मे बी फोटो ऑटोट्रॉफिक और मे बी कीमो ऑटोट्रॉफिक. इट मे बी फोटो ऑटोट्रॉफिक मीन्स विद द हेल्प ऑफ लाइट एनर्जी दिस टाइप ऑफ न्यूट्रिशन कैन बी परफॉर्म, और इट मे बी कीमो ऑटोट्रॉफिक मीन्स विद द हेल्प ऑफ chemical energy, right? Now, heterotrophic mode of nutrition are of three types. It may be parasitic, it may be saprophytic, and it may be symbiotic. So, out of these three mode of heterotrophic nutrition, the most common mode of heterotrophic nutrition is this. This is the most common. Okay? Most common among all these three types of the heterotrophic mode of nutrition. Next is reproduction. Reproduction, agar dekhe, to it performs only asexual reproduction. Sexual reproduction is absent. So, only asexual reproduction is mein hota hai. And asexual reproduction kaise hota hai? By the means of the fission, budding, by spore formation, by fragmentation. So, various modes are there. You can write these modes by fission, by budding, by spore formation or by fragmentation, kyunki filamentous organism bhi kuch present hote hain, to fragmentation ke through bhi hota hai. But sexual reproduction is totally absent. Yahan pe sexual reproduction is absent. Haan, lekin genetic recombination is present in these organisms. So, genetic recombination is present. Genetic recombination in organism mein present rahega, parantu sexual reproduction absent hota hai. Now, as we see that the sexual reproduction is absent, so spindle formation will also absent. Spindle formation will not take place in case of prokaryotic organism, and motility is found in such organisms. There are motile. So this motility is due to the flagella. So flagella is present, but it is unistranded. Unistranded means jaise humne यूकैरियोटिक जब सेल पढ़ सेल हम पढ़ते हैं सेल हम पढ़ेंगे आप पढ़ेंगे तो उसमें आप देखेंगे कि सेल में जो यूकैरियोटिक सेल में जो फ्लैजला होता है इसमें 11 स्ट्रैंड्स पड़े होते प्रेजेंट होते हैं 9+2 अरेंजमेंट होता है राइट बट हियर इन दिस केस फ्लैजला ओनली सिंगल स्ट्रैंड इज प्रेजेंट एंड दिस स्ट्रैंड इज मेड ऑफ द प्रोटीन मेड अप ऑफ द प्रोटीन दैट इज फ्लैजेलिन ठीक है नाउ These prokaryotic organisms, these monerans, they play very important role in nitrogen fixation, right? They play very important role in nitrogen fixation. Nitrogen fixation mein, they play role in nitrification. They play role in ammonification. Ammonification, denitrification, okay, nitrogen fixation. So they play very important role, and all the type of the bacteria means free living bacteria and the symbiotic bacteria, they both are involved in such type of nitrogen fixation. Free living bacteria bhi perform karega nitrogen fixation or and symbiotic bacteria. These two bacteria, they will perform nitrogen fixation. So now in this way you can see that the structural organization of the bacteria or the monera or the organisms of the monera, it is very simple, but their behavior is very complex, right? And there's so very diverse metabolic activities. So bacteria ke baare mein hum keh sakte hain, basically especially for the organisms of the monera, their structure is simple, but their behavior is complex. and they show diverse metabolic activities. So these are few characteristic features of the kingdom Monera. Now next I will be dealing with the sole members, with the very important member or the sole member of the kingdom Monera, that is bacteria, in detail. Thank you.